all right.
It's been a long time, hasn't it, Velvet? I wanted to apologize to you for ages now.
Apologize? What for?
That business with Arthur. Back then, I said he seemed like a fraud. I know you took it pretty hard, but if he wasn't there 3 years ago, our village would have been destroyed. I'm sorry I doubted him.
I didn't trust him then either. I only realized how amazing of a person he was when he saved all of our lives. I'm ashamed of myself. All this time we've been feeling terrible, thinking we may have driven you to leave the village. Please, forgive us.
That's not... I didn't...
Where have you been these past 3 years? It must have been tough living on your own, without any family to help you. Sorry, you don't have to talk about it if it hurts. But if you ever feel like talking, we're here for you.
I know we can't make up for all the pain we put you through, but if there's anything we can do, just ask. And if you'd like, you're always welcome to come back. The whole village would welcome you with open arms.
Between the cold, the famine, and the demon blight, there were times I thought the world was done for. But over the past 3 years, I've stopped worrying.
I know we're overly reliant on Arthur and the exorcists, but this village has changed. The exorcists taught us that there are things the demons hate. We can't defeat them, but we can keep them away.
It's peaceful now. The exorcists stop by on patrol every now and then. We haven't had a case of demon blight since what happened to your sister was horrible. But you and Lafayette should try to move on. Make the most of your lives.
I hope he wakes up soon.
I'm sure he will.
You haven't changed a whit.
What do you mean by that?
Have you seen Nico yet?
I have.
She's as full of life as she always was, right? Come to think of it, nothing's really changed much, has it?
I suppose not. By the way, how are Orthy and Russ doing?
Those pups haven't changed a whit either. They saw a guy with a big sword walking with a dour-eyed fellow in black. They freaked out and hightailed it.
That would be Rokuro and Aizen.
Those dogs are as cowardly as always.
So, what part of Velvet hasn't changed a whit?
She doesn't have any makeup on?
Uh-huh.
The coming of the Malachim are a gift from the Empyreans. A reward for our repentance and our renewed prayers. The Malachim are our blades against the demons. And the exorcists, the hands that wield them. Humanity's hope.
You never change. Want me to take you home this time?
No! Don't treat me like I'm senile!
Okay.
Oh! It's you, Velvet. Be careful when fighting prickle boars.
If they charge you, punch them in the nose, right?
No! Throw sand in their eyes!
Sand in the eyes. Got it.
You finally started listening to me. You're 16. You've really grown.
Yeah.
16? But aren't you 19?
Leave her be. Hey, could I get some eggs, milk, spinach, and tomatoes? And I'd love to know what cheese you'd recommend, too.
You got it. And in celebration of your homecoming, I won't even charge. With you cooking up a feast like that, I'm sure Lafayette will wake up straight away.
Thanks. I really appreciate it.
You're getting spinach? I can't really handle it myself.
You'll never grow up strong if you don't eat your spinach, young lady.
I've done just fine without it so far, thank you.
Oh, if you insist, I'll leave it out just this once.
Wow, Velvet, you must be special. Not many folks get to be friends with an exorcist.
She's not my friend!
The way you two bicker, I find that hard to believe.
Oh, yeah. Do you have any prickle boar?
Oh, I'm sorry to say that I'm out at the moment.
That's fine. I'll hunt some up myself in the tranquil woods. Just like old times.
Actually, there haven't been any prickle boars there lately. You should try the Morgana Woods instead.
Okay, I'll do that. Thanks for the tip.
You don't like spinach, right, Eleanor?
Well, you know, I just... All right, it's true, but keep that between us, okay?
Velvet really seemed to be enjoying herself at the shop.
Quite. And she can really pick out a nice balance of foods while making every gold count. She seems so cheerful and carefree.
That's the real Velvet. I'm sure of it.
Yes. An ordinary, dutiful, loving sister.
I wish she could have stayed that way. She could have lived a happy life, surrounded by her friends.
Just plain Velvet Crow, sister to Lord Artorias.
And maybe not Lord Artorias, but just plain Arthur.
A happy, ordinary life for an ordinary girl, with a kind family and supportive friends.
All right.
Scout!
To the Morgana Woods to hunt some prickle boars.
Yeah, sure.
We're looking for prickle boars. Keep your eyes on the thickets.
Yeah!
stop fooling around.
But I'm serious about my fooling around! We can do this!
They were nothing.
This is hunting?
We keep this up and who knows how many we'll bring home. They were nothing. Okay, this should be enough. Huh? What's wrong?
Nothing. I just feel a little sorry for them is all.
I hear you. These prickle boars might have all been family. People can be so heartless.
Yeah, I'd forgotten this feeling. But what can you do? At the end of the day, we have to eat just as much as they do.
Yes, what can you do in this situation indeed?
Luffy's waiting for us. We should run on home now.
Luffy. Shopping, hunting, laughing with friends. That was how our life used to be, wasn't it?
Yes, but my own past.
Huh? But wasn't your village... I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. The happy times I shared with my family, I still treasure those memories. And even after the attack, I've still been able to find happiness. Eating a good meal, making new friends...
And falling in love?
Yes, falling in...
love?
Look what you made me say, Bianfu!
There's nothing to be ashamed of. Most every girl's happiest memories are of her first love, after all. Don't you think there was someone special out there Velvet had feelings for?
A first love? Do you really think so?
That's enough of that talk, Bianfu. You sound like an old man.
No! I'm only 150 years old and already being treated like an old man!
But still, I would like to meet the guy Velvet first fell for.
I wouldn't.
I see. You're a guy.
Scout ship...
Thank you.
Heard the news about your brother. I'm happy for you.
So, what's your plan now?
You guys were snooping around the village.
Yeah, we wanted to check out that shrine too, but we got stopped. Apparently, the Abbey's designated it off-limits. If there's a Therian around, it's probably there.
I'm going to draw it out. If this is a trap, things may turn violent. Either way, this place is about to get a lot less tranquil.
The same as everywhere else I've been.
You can quit here if you like, but I'm going to keep on fighting the Abbey.
And if I try to stop you, you'll insist, I presume.
Velvet, no!
I'll give you one day. Once you've made up your mind, come meet me at the Cape.
I'm with him. How tomorrow shakes out depends on what you decide, Velvet.
Your hand. It's...
As you can see, I'm a demon. 3 years ago, I was the one who attacked this village.
I don't want to hear it! Demon, or no demon, you're still you! Okay, so you're scary! I'll get used to it. I promise, I'll keep it a secret. Let's just live here in the village like we used to, okay? You, me, and everyone else.
Nico.
That was rather good, Velvet.
Yeah. Lafayette gets a gold star for being such a good taste tester, too!
Tomorrow, I'll fix you up a nice stew.
Hey, is this... It's the original copy of the book on Enominat! And all the pages are here! Velvet...
Hey, Fee. Can I borrow your compass real quick? I'll give it right back. Please?
All right.
He really wanted a compass, more than anything else. Just like you, he loved to stare out at the sea, wondering what's on the other side. He wanted to go adventuring someday.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I bet once he wakes up, you two will be really good friends.
So, this is what your life used to be like before everything happened, huh?
What's gotten into you? Maybe I made the pudding a little too sweet.
Velvet? How do you know what it tastes like?
I think I'll get myself some shut-eye. But what are you going to do about tomorrow?
Mogilu, are there arts that let the caster...